Welcome, bienvenidos, rejoice. We gather on this fourth Sunday of Lent and we rejoice. We are halfway through the Lenten journey toward Easter. The God who called us into being is filling us with his love. We will continue our special collection, bringing relief to our two sister parishes in South Texas, Sacred Heart and Queen of Peace. If you haven't had the opportunity to partner with us in this good work, you may still do so by sending in your gift to the parish office. In the name of those receiving your help, God bless you and thank you. We have another wonderful opportunity for you, hosted by our Whole Person Healthcare Ministry. Join us for a seminar entitled The Essentials of Medicare on Tuesday, March 16th at 6:30 in English, and on Thursday, March 18th at 6:30 in Spanish. All of the information you'll need is, and the Zoom link, is on our website. Also, Gospel Hangouts are this week. Join Peggy and I on either Wednesday evening or Friday morning for a little gospel fun. And for a really special treat in our ongoing adult faith formation series, this month, on Thursday, March 25th, Trevor will be facilitating a wonderful lesson on Holy Week, the Triduum, and the sacred music that goes along with these beautiful feasts. Check out the bulletin for all the info you need. Our presider today is Father John. Let's pause now, allowing God's Spirit to quiet our hearts and still our minds. Let us offer our intentions for the Mass from within our hearts. And for the Mass intentions, for the safe return of our school teachers, faculty, staff, parents, and students as they return to in-person learning. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
So together, let us rise, greeting those who are with you, and join Candace and Trevor in praying our gathering song.
Oh, love of God, gather us amor de Dios, haznos uno, that we may share the gifts we are given para construir la comunidad, para construir la comunidad. Haznos una familia que se una por obras de tu amor. Oh, love of God, gather us, amor de Dios, haznos uno, that we may share the gifts we are given para construir la comunidad, para construir la comunidad.
And we're gathered in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. And the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
And with your spirit.
So, good morning. Good morning, Father. So, today is Lectare Sunday. It marks the midway through Lent. So, half of our Lent observance is over, and we're on the downhill now to Easter. And so let us place ourselves before the Lord and ask him to help us in our preparations for the Easter celebration. Jesus, lover of our souls, you seek us out once more, offering healing and transformation. Lord Jesus, you are the outcast, you are the poor. You are the family member silently crying out of attention, waiting, lifting up from our selfishness and lift our eyes to your needs.
Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison.
Christ Jesus, you are the neighbor who is broken. You are the homeless with no bed. You are the loving spouse with your arms wide open. Lift us up from our darkness and lift our eyes to your needs.
Christe eleison. Christe eleison.
Lord Jesus, you are the other who comes to us asking for help. In need of compassion, lift us up from our pride. Lift our eyes to your needs.
Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison.
May God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and lead us to everlasting life through Christ our Lord. Amen. And let us pray. Loving God, it is the power of your love that lifts us, frees us, and empowers us. As we open ourselves to receive you, fill us and shape us as you please. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
A reading from the second book of Chronicles. In those days, all princes of Judah, the priests and the people, added infidelity to infidelity, practicing all the abominations of nations and polluting the Lord's temple, which he had consecrated in Jerusalem. Early and often did the Lord, the God of their fathers, send his messengers to them, for he had compassion on his people and his dwelling place. But they mocked the messengers of God, despised his warnings, and scoffed at his prophets, until the anger of the Lord against his people was so inflamed that there was no remedy. Their enemies burnt the house of God, tore down the walls of Jerusalem, set all its palaces afire, and destroyed all its precious objects. Those who escaped the sword were carried captive to Babylon, where they became servants of the king of the Chaldeans and his sons, until the kingdom of the Persians came to power. All this was to fulfill the word of the Lord spoken by Jeremiah. Until the land has retrieved its lost Sabbaths, during all the time it lies waste, it shall have rest, while 70 years are fulfilled. In the first year of Cyrus, king of Persia, in order to fulfill the word of the Lord spoken by Jeremiah, the Lord inspired King Cyrus of Persia to issue this proclamation throughout his kingdom, both by word of mouth and in writing. Thus says Cyrus, king of Persia, all the kingdoms of the earth the Lord, the God of heaven, has given to me. And he has also charged me to build him a house in Jerusalem, which is in Judah. Whoever, therefore, among you belongs to any part of his people, let him go up, and may his God be with him. The word of the Lord.
God.
Let my tongue be silenced if I ever forget you.
Let's pray together.
Let my tongue be silenced if I ever forget you. By the streams of Babylon we sat and wept
when we remember Zion. On the aspens of that land, we hung up our harps. For there our captors asked of us, sing for us the lyrics of our songs. And our despoilers urged us to be joyous, sing for us the songs of Zion, the songs of Zion. Let my tongue be silenced if I ever forget you. Let my tongue be silenced if I ever forget you. How could we sing a song to the Lord in a foreign land? If I forget you, Jerusalem, may my right hand be forgotten. My tongue cleave to my palate if I remember you not. If I place not Jerusalem, place not Jerusalem ahead of my joy, ahead of my joy. Let my tongue be silenced if I ever forget you. Let my tongue be silenced if I ever forget you.
Lectura de la carta del apóstol San Pablo a los Efesios. Hermanos, la misericordia y el amor de Dios son muy grandes, porque nosotros estábamos muertos por nuestros pecados y Él nos dio la vida con Cristo y en Cristo. Por pura generosidad suya hemos sido salvados. Con Cristo y en Cristo nos ha resucitado y con Él nos ha reservado un sitio en el cielo. Así, en todos los tiempos, Dios muestra por medio de Jesús la incomparable riqueza de su gracia y de su bondad para con nosotros. En efecto, ustedes han sido salvados por la gracia mediante la fe. Y esto no se debe a ustedes mismos, sino que es un don de Dios. Tampoco se debe a las obras, para que nadie pueda presumir, porque somos hechura de Dios, creados por medio de Cristo Jesús para hacer el bien que Dios ha dispuesto que hagamos. Palabra de Dios.
Te alabamos, Señor.
Glory to you. So loved the world that He gave His only Son, so that everyone who believes in Him might have eternal life. Glory to You.
Jesus Christ.
And the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And a reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to Nicodemus, "Just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the desert, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, so that everyone who believes in him may have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him might not perish, but have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him. Whoever believes in him will not be condemned, but whoever does not believe has already been condemned, because he has not believed in the name of the only Son of God. And this is the verdict, that the light came into the world, but people prefer darkness to the light, because their works were evil. For everyone who does wicked things hates the light, and does not come towards the light, so that his works might not be exposed. But whoever lives the truth comes to the light, so that his works may be clearly seen as done in God." The Gospel of the Lord. I know it's a burning question, but I bet you've been wondering, you know, when you see the spacemen go out, or the space women these days, go out from the spaceships, there's a cord that attaches to their spacesuit. And I bet you've been wondering what the part number of that is. It's a J316. The engineer who designed the lock on the spacesuit and the umbilical cord that comes from the spacesuit, he was a Christian, and so he numbered it J316 and a J317. So if you're ever in a quiz and somebody asks, what's the part number of the spacesuit? Now you know, it's a J316 and a J317. And it's so John 3:16, it's probably one of the most loved verses in the Bible. And how many times have you seen people lift up plaques like that, with J316 on it? It's a lot of games you find people holding up those plaques. And it's a very favorite quote from the Bible. But what we have to remember is that it's sandwiched between two other parts, that the lifting up of the Son of Man and the judgment or condemnation of those who refuse to believe. And so the three elements are united in one unit there. And the link, Jesus, just as Moses lifted up the serpent. And if you look at somebody who's a doctor or a nurse or that, and they have a badge, it's a cross with a snake around it. And that's where this comes from. It's as Moses lifted up the stick and the serpent, so whoever was bitten by a serpent, they were cured. And so that's the sign of the medical profession, the cross with the snake wrapped around it. And so just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up. And lifting up the Son of Man, it refers to three things. So it goes back to the image that Moses gave us of lifting the serpent on the stick. And it refers to the cross and also the resurrection and the ascension. So Jesus will be lifted up onto the cross, the great paschal sacrifice, and he will be raised on the third day, lifted up on the third day to new life. And then he's raised up again, lifted up again to sit at the right hand of the Father. And so so being lifted up is, it's brings us eternal life. And so you might ask, well, what is eternal life? The Jews divided time into three things. So there was that which was completed, and so that was the past tense. And then there's the present age and the age to come. And in this is one of the things about translating the Bible. Hebrews only had two tenses. It was either past, it was done, or it's in the present, going to the future. And so the age to come had no end. They didn't know when the end was ever going to be. And so just like we don't know how long, you know, this present age will go on for. And so those who believe in Jesus, they've already stepped into eternity. And so what happens is with death is we change the mode of our existence in that period of time, in that eternity. And so and it all depends on our relationship with the Lord. So another gospel, John 14, he says, in my Father's house there are many rooms. And that's because it depends on our level of relationship with the Lord. How much can we share in his life? And that's the purpose of this life, is to get closer and closer to the Lord, so that the more we can share his life in the future. And so by choosing the Lord and developing our relationship with him, it helps us to share more and more in his life and what he's about. But those who refuse to believe in the Lord, they don't look towards the Lord, and so they remain in the earth. They're caught up with earthly values and earthly things, and so they're bound to the earth, and they're buried in the earth, and they don't rise. And so so that's why it's important to choose the Lord, because it leads us into eternal life. And so we step into that eternal life now. And the more that we develop our relationship with the Lord, the more that we can join in with him in the next life. And so it's very important to develop that relationship. And so let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation he came down from heaven, and by the power of the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. And let us pray now for our needs and the needs of the church.
Our response is, we thank you and we trust you.
We thank you and we trust you.
For all those who continue to do the work to keep us healthy as they work day to day, keep them safe, renew their strength, and fill them with new hope. For our elect and our candidates who continue their journey towards Easter, that they may experience a renewed conversion of heart and mind, we pray.
We thank you and we trust you.
For all who are estranged from their families, that God will bring healing to their hearts and guide them to forgiveness and reconciliation. For those in our community who feel unloved, outcast, or different, that they may experience the love of Christ through the works of compassion, we pray.
We thank you and we trust you.
For the poor, the homeless, and the marginalized, that their needs be met through our generosity, we pray.
We thank you and we trust you.
For our sacred sick and all in need of healing of mind, body, or spirit, and for those who love them and care for them, may they be renewed. For all who have died, bring them home to you, and may those who mourn their passing be comforted. We pray.
We thank you and we trust you. And let us make our own special prayer now to the Lord. God, our source of life and light, thank you for hearing and answering our prayers through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us pray that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
And let us pray. We place before you with joy these offerings which bring eternal remedy, O Lord, praying that we may both fairly revere them and present them to you, as is fitting for the salvation of all the world, through Christ our Lord. Amen. And the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And let us lift up our hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering cancelled out our sins. By his rising from the dead he has opened the way to eternal life, and by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Santo, Santo, Santo,
Santo, Santo, Señor.
Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna en el cielo.
Indeed, holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by this same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, to be shed for you and for many, so that sins will be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon your oblation of the Church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with her husband, Saint Joseph, with the apostles, the martyrs, and all the saints, on whose constant intercession we rely for help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope, Jose our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people your Son has gained for you. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, and to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. For through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
us pray now in the words that Jesus taught his disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every fear and evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin. Protect us from all anxiety, to wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
And the peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Peace, peace.
On you stay, quitoles peccata mundi, miserere nobis. On you stay, quitoles peccata mundi, miserere nobis. On you stay, quitoles peccata mundi, dona nobis pacem.
And this is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Happy we who are called to his supper. Lord, I'm not worthy you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. And may the body and blood of Christ bring us to everlasting life. Spiritual Communion Prayer. Jesus, lover of my soul, I love you, I believe in you, and I want to receive you into the depths of my being. Humbly I come to you, knowing that I am in need of your transforming love. Help me to be more like Mary, letting your will be done in my life. Empower me to live by faith, like the saints who inspire me. Those are holy men and women who pray for me on my journey. Because I cannot receive you in the Holy Eucharist, I open my heart and my soul to you now, receiving you and welcoming you in a mystical and spiritual way. Fill me with your love, O Lord, I place my trust in you and give you permission to work in me as you please, through Christ our Lord. Amen. And let us pray. With the power of your love, our Lord, you lift us up. Freed and strengthened by your Spirit, send us out to love and serve your people. May your will be done in us and through us, through Christ our Lord. Amen. So a couple of notices on behalf of our health ministry. Thank you all who participated in our blood drive. It was successful beyond measure. And speaking of successful, we filled up our pantry once again because of you. Your generosity really never ceases to amaze us. Thank you so very much from all those who serve in God's name. And make sure you get your fish fry tickets this weekend. The last day to purchase them will be on Tuesday, and you don't want to miss out. So that's the fish fry. Make sure you get your tickets this weekend. So there was a pastor not too far from here, and he was always improving the church. And this one week he installed electric hand dryers in the toilets. And he took them out after the first weekend because someone had put a notice on the hand dryer, press here for next week's sermon. So let us ask the Lord to bless us now, be with us, and to be especially mindful of our families and our friends. And the Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. And the Mass is ended. Let's go forth in peace to love and to serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.